Now, I move to the next one under fluvial erosion, gully erosion and management. And there the isolated area in the intervening zone of Gangetic Plain and Peninsular India. And there, 80 kilometers to the south of Allahabad, that's the gullied area, we have selected it, and I will tell you that we monitored all the geomorphological, meteorological, hydrological parameters for 4 years in continuation through three months of monsoon period, July, August and September. Day and night, our team stayed in the field and we generated a mass data set about hydrological aspect, geomorphological aspect, sedimentological aspect, and so on. So, the overview of the release of that area, the examples I am showing you. Here is seen whatever the slope of the gully was 60 to 70 degrees, sometimes it rises to 80 degrees. And whatever. Here you see, these are the points, you know. Anyway, you find this is linear, you can say the light there is here. They have been plowed by tractor. Can you imagine? These are cultivated areas. They grow, you can say the here in India we call whenever there is rain, the water flows through the furrows plowed by the tractor and that becomes a rain. In the sediments are deposited in the form of a fan and next storm then comes, then it is again furrowed, like this has been furrowed, divided into two parts. And that fine has been, you can say, loaded down in the form of belief. You know, in one season, last monsoon, there was a lot of sediments are deposited there. And in July, when there is a first rainstorm, that is, the erosion starts like this in stages, and they are brought to the river. What did we do in that area? These are the few pictures. These are a few instruments that we applied in the area, the evapometer, the rain gauges, the thermometer, dimension scheme, kept, and to measure the meteorological instrument, meteorological parameters, and evaporation. And these are the instruments we used there. We just placed there a flue. And this ultrasonic flowmeter and galvanized seed, this is the one room set there. That means this is put in the galvanized seed house, yeah, room, and sensor is just there. And what was the problem in that area? You know, whenever the storm comes, then the water flows. But if there is deposition of seed and no water flow, then the sensor senses. And that gives flow. That's why we had to employ two laborers to remove the silt from the base of the flume. And that was done 4 years, 91 to 94, day and night, whenever the rain storms came over there. And we generated a mass data set. All the sediments were trapped in the sedimental tray. Erosion pins were used for vertical erosion. Discharge was measured through this instrument. All the parameters were measured
regularly, day and night, whenever the rainy storms come. Suppose the rainy storm comes 2 o'clock in the night and the area is very risky. So we have to employ 8 local peoples. Otherwise, they might have taken all the instruments from there. Then what? We also map the area in the topographical maps of 1 to 50,000 scale, there is not even single contour. But here we just trace the contour in the field with computable at the interval of 1 meter. And I will show you this. These are the 3 year sequence, the continuous measurement, the plotting. And here, you know, there is a slight flattening, if you saw very closely, slight flattening of the area. And the rate of erosion, you will wonder what happened, you know, when we went to in 1991, then 2/3 of gullies and the area is only 6 hectares. Only 6 hectares. We placed there 6 rain gauges and there was a spatial variation within 6 hectares area. So 2/3 area was cultivated and 1/3 area was vegetated of the secondary succession. And what happened in 1993, that was also removed by the farmers. And we were so lucky that we got a base for this line. What happened about the area when it was in 1993 vegetated? What was the scenario of erosion in 1994 after devegetation of area? And that is the human factor that will come before you. This was the result. 3 times within a year, the vertical or total erosion was 3 times. Human factor is so dominant. Right from this area to Chambal, you go to the west. The same badland area. Now I move on to second one. This is from Gully Development and Maharashtra Upland by Professor Veena Joshi, sitting over here in a beautiful sari. Pune University, she selected 2 basins. First, you see the Ramayana's area, scenario number 1, 2, badland area, Maharashtra plant, and this is the one gully, putting gully coming down, and here is the process of gully formation. At the top, you see the water sinks there and appears here. That is the piping system, which was already explained by Professor H.S. Sharma of Jaipur University in 1968, the process of gully formation through tunneling, and you see the result. Now there, the same collapse, and if you see at the head, there is the difference, you see the tunnel like that, and that is going on. Now see, attempted to determine the loss of soil through erosion pin system. These are the 2 basins selected for the study. And this is one, left one is the map position, right one is the ground position. The second basin, left map position, ground position. And here are the locations of erosion pins, where erosion pins were used. And now here the monitoring of gullies with profilometer, and these are being set by her in the field. Next one. Yeah. Now the rainfall simulator experiment, the Department of Geography, prestigious Department of Geography, University of Pune. And here they will bring to the field. Yeah, that has been brought to the field. And this is the model developed to provide water on a trolley, that is the moving trolley. And now move on to the third study of gullies. That the one was the intervening zone of Gangetic Plain Peninsula in India. The second was of Maharashtra upland. Now third, we take you to the coastal areas, Midnapur Plain, RK Maiti. instrumentation and experimentation. This has been generated in the laboratory in geography department, Vidya Sagar University. I have seen there in the department. He showed me artificially generated channel. And here the primary is secondary. You can say move, you have primary wave flow and secondary flow here measured. Now this is the collapsing of the riparian trap, and now the plot experiment to trap the sediments and how much sediments, suspended sediment, goes out. This is the equation for the spacing, and in the field now these are the waves. And actually that has been constructed. This is the model that has been constructed in the field. And different years, 2008, 2009, 2010, others. Different areas, what is happening here, the stone blocks have been put there to check the gullies. And now this is a very important work by my team. That is, plume experiment to monitor role of below the ground vegetation, biomass, that is in the field and that is in the laboratory, in the department. Now the laboratory experimentation. Here, now the soils, suspended soils taken out, is being filtered. And now that is washed out to take only the grains in that area. Now here you know, just with the vegetation. So the root density, the buttress, and what type of vegetation is useful to heal the gully, to reclaim the gully, and practically they have done so. Green grasses you see there, they have been planted by Dr. Mikey and his team. And here in the lower part you can see, and the vegetation root mess you can see there, that can hold the soil and can check it from erosion. Now I move to the coast, the coastal area. I selected one. So many persons are doing work on coastal geomorphology in India, but S.N. Karlekar of Pune University, that is the Konkan coast of Maharashtra in the west. This is the morphology of that area. Instrument, measuring. Now using hand auger to take sediments for analysis. This is the beach ridges. This major work is on beach ridges. The deposits in between, different deposits. Same thing, sections. Now I move to the second one. The grasses fall from MS University, Vidya Sagar University, Medinapur, along the east coast. Now here, they are taking sample of sediments near the mud bank of Subanrekha Delta. Using hand auger to take sand sample, sand bank of Subanrekha estuary. And here they are taking water.